Fire, air, water, sky, earth. These five elements sometimes cause discomfort to the body. And man with science, man with technology conquers the five elements, makes them his slaves, makes them comfortable to him. We are able to construct beautiful buildings to protect ourselves from the external nature. We have invented AC for a conducive, favorable, good, comfortable life. And we are able to find several things for the pleasure of the body. These are all indications of civilization. In the Ramayana, you find the place of Ravana fully civilized, highly sophisticated. Every house has a lift system. The roads are very, very clean, dust free. And everybody has a helicopter. On the top of the house, there is a helipad for everybody. And the best aeroplane was available with Ravan. And such a wonderful aeroplane that it would always provide place for the last person. If there are 100 people in the aircraft, there is a place for the 101 first person. This is highly expandable. Most up-to-date technological devices are available in the Lanka of Sri Mr. Ravan. In spite of all the comforts, in spite of all the pleasures available in Lanka, the fellow was unable to sleep. You may buy the cot, may not be able to sleep. You may buy everything in the world, but you may not have the peace of mind. Peace of mind cannot be purchased. Love cannot be bought. The internal happiness cannot be acquired. It has to be cultivated. It has to be cultured. And the internal nature consists of six. Number one, lust. The moment a person sees a girl, whatever may be his age, what thought comes to his mind is an indication of one's culture. If it is the flesh appetite that comes to the mind of the person, he is least cultured. Ravan had only a dirty look at every woman. He tried to seduce every beautiful girl. He tried to trap every woman. If the girl was not agreeable to his approaches, to his advances, he did not hesitate to rape the woman. And that fellow was unable to conquer the lust within. Therefore, whatever may be the sophisticated life he was leading, whatever available things were present for his physical comfort, he was unable to have a peace of mind. He was unable to be happy at heart. All the problem was with his lust. Similarly, in Mahabharata, you have that Duryodhan. That Duryodhan had all the comforts in Hastinapur. He had the palatial building. He had the sophisticated modern devices. He has all the pleasures at his command, but he is unable to sleep. He is unable to have that internal happiness simply because he was unable to conquer the internal nature, jealousy. These two are the vital enemies inside. One is kama, lust. The other is greed or grabbing tendency. I may be a millionaire, I would like to add some more to my wealth. And there is a pride. Pride on account of power, pride on account of position. Vali was unable to remain peaceful because he was conceited. There was a pride in him. Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Mada, Matsarya, these are the six internal enemies or internal aspects of nature. Five elements outside you may conquer, And you may appear to be highly civilized. The six internal enemies are to be conquered, to be cultured. And these powerful enemies, one is lust and the other is jealousy. One may conquer even lust but not jealousy. If my neighbor is richer, I cannot have the peace of mind. One day, I was having my morning coffee in my house, a beautiful building, an obedient wife, an imported car, excellent comfort. She gave me the fuming cup of coffee. She looked at my face and said, "Same wife is giving coffee, same chair you are occupying, same house we are living in, the car is happy, comfortable, the son is quite okay in US, the daughter is okay in London, everything is very, very comfortable. Today, I find you to be more sorrowful. What's the reason, my fast?" And I showed my neighbor's house through the window. That man has bought a new car. Everything is comfortable with me. I am not peaceful. Why? My neighbor has bought the car. Not because he has become rich. He should not become rich. Jealousy is twofold. One, I want to be the richest. Nobody should be rich. Everybody should be poor. It's not enough. My son becomes IAS. My neighbor's son should not get a job. In the misery of others, I build castles. As long as this weakness is present in man's heart, he or she is not cultured. Physical culture is possible through the exercises. Psychic culture is possible only when you conquer these six enemies. What steps are we taking? Patanjali is very, very particular about the internal conquest. You take Yama, the five subdivisions. You take Niyama, the five subdivisions. The entire Yoga Shastra of Vasishtha. The entire Yoga Shastra of Patanjali. Everywhere, the very minutest aspect is shown for the physical fitness. And we are highlighting that. Let us not confine ourselves to the physical concept of yoga. There are higher dimensions. There is a higher ladder to be climbed up. There are the conquests inside. And you find the culture to be present in India. Many people are of the view that the sophistication of the West is a civilization. Swami Vivekananda is of the view, modern civilization is skin deep. Scratch a little, the beast pounces. I am angry, I am burning with pride. Somebody calls me over phone and I use sweet words, there is a boiling heat inside and that causes disease. When I am civilized and not cultured, it causes blood pressure. It causes sugar, just like the balloon with boiling water inside. The balloon is beautiful. The balloon apparently is soft. The person is soft, sweet, spoken. But inside the heart is burning with anger, anguish. Possessiveness, greed, and when this contradiction is present, when this conflict is present, when this contrast is present, when you put on a smiling face, concealing the anger inside, we become subjects, victims to the diseases. Most executives suffer from stress because of this contradiction. The man from Delhi will be calling over phone, yes sir, with all sweet words we will be obedient to the minister, and here it is burning. The moment you place the phone, you will be shouting at the subordinate. Anger on one side, external appearance of sweetness on another side, this contradiction causes all the ailments, and that ailment first is caused in the mind. It is called adhi. We may go to many places for doing exercises, pranayama, but still, as long as we are unable to be cultured, we cannot become yogis. When we are thinking of the stress management, when we are thinking of developing our own health, we must concentrate on the inward change. If Sri Ramachandra Prabhu was able to be peaceful, it was because of the internal conquest. If Yudhishthira was able to be successful, it is because of the conquest of the inner feelings. And this adhi will not enter into a mind where there is the peace. And that peace is not possible through the external means. That peace is possible only when we conquer the internal mind of the six facets, lust, greed, etc. How, sir? And that how is only by cultivating only one dimension, advesta sarva bhutanam maitraha karunayevacha nirmamo nirahankaraha santustaha satatam naraha. Be contented with what you have. Don't aspire for somebody else's property. Don't be greedy. Don't try to develop that grabbing tendency. God is great, this is enough for me. After all, for me today's food is sufficient. Why should I think of somebody else's? That contentment is the first step for attaining that internal culture. Similarly, love. Gautamadi Buddha was unable to touch even a flower because he felt the pain when he touched the flower or the fruit or the plant's leaf. Are our thoughts really loving? Are our words really loving? If there is love outside and if there is love inside, then there is no contradiction, there is no stress. When there is hatred inside and when there is love outside, there is a contradiction. When there is a contradiction, when there is a contrast, when there is a conflict, then it is the cause for all ailments. Simplest thing is, we speak of moral uprightness, we practice bad life. The students, when they come to the university or the college, when they look at the girls, they call them di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di. But in the heart, in the mind, very beautiful, very beautiful. And the girl looks at him, anna, 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 bhaiya, bhaiya, bhaiya. The fellow is very handsome. Within few days, the thoughts change, there is a contradiction. Similarly, all the evils, practice is essential. The contradiction between the external and the internal causes the ailment. Let us be loving inside, let us be loving outside. Let us be contented inside, let us be satisfied outside. Let us be modest inside, let us be humble outside. Let us be simple inside, let us be simple outside. When there is no contradiction, then there is no conflict, we are really peaceful. Let us try to aim at that cultured life. All our great masters in India, the great rishis, were cultured. They gave preference to culture, not the external sophistication and the hypocritic civilization. Let's meditate on that great Lord Sri Ramachandra Prabhu, who has been peaceful on account of his culture.